I don't think it comes as a surprise, but I love the Faroe Islands. Like, of course. It was only a question about time when I would return to these islands, and when I got the opportunity here in midsummer, I knew I just had to go. So here are a couple of new videos in my series from the Faroe Islands. And right now I'm at Tjørnuvik, but we will start at the island of Vagar.
In 2018, I have visited the Faroe Islands on several occasions throughout the year. In this part of the series, I will not focus on individual islands in all of the episodes, even though I do have some of those prepared too. As an example, in this episode, we will visit three different locations from three of the islands I have already covered in the first batch of videos. Be sure to hit the bell icon next to the subscription button to be notified whenever I upload a new video. So without further ado, let's get started, and we'll start at the island of Vagar.
So we have come down here to the lakeside of Laitisvatn, which is the largest lake on the island of Vagar. You can see down here, there's this sculpture, which is a fairly new sculpture. I think it's only been here for like half a year or something like that. At the very end of this lake, it's the waterfall Bøsdalafossur and Trillanipa, which you will remember if you've seen the first episode of my Faroe Island series. The location here is super easy to find. The main road is just up here, and there's an entrance up here. You drive down through a gravel road and then down to the lake. And I don't think we parked at the right point, but at least there's no one else here today, so we're not in the way of anyone. But right now, I want to photograph this sculpture, and I'm feeling really optimistic about it. I think it's a super cool sculpture. The idea is to make a long exposure to smooth out the water, and then make a single normal exposure for the sky to have some texture in the clouds. But I've tried out a few different things. A central composition of the sculpture, as you can see here, and then one with negative space with the water, and one with negative space as the sky. So I'm switching between placing the sculpture in the upper third and in the lower third. So all in all, super simple. And I'm using a 10-stop filter to smooth out the water to get that 30 seconds, even if I'm shooting at f14, f16. I can only go to 30 seconds of an exposure. Pretty basic. It's usually always the same aperture and ISO I shoot at. ISO 100 and aperture of 11 to 16. You can see how here in the background we have one hill or mountain here and over here, and how they collect, and I have the horse coming out of the water just in between. So it is, yeah, well, the most obvious composition also. So there are actually quite a lot of opportunities for some interesting foregrounds, which is not just negative space. The problem is just that I feel, at least for my picture and my vision about this place, that the sculpture doesn't really look that good from straight on. So you have to take it from the side to get all the details of the head and the legs. And during night or evening, the light comes on, and in this case, it's a beautiful blue turquoise teal light. I quite like it. It has to be a bit more dark than it is right now for it to pop a bit more. We have driven past during night when it was a bit more dark, not entirely dark, and it looked really, really great. The light kind of bounces off on the metal, so it gets, it looks like it gets evenly light all night.
The next location on the list is located on Streymoy and is a location you might not even be able to photograph while you are in the Faroes. It is one of the views located far above the sea, and chances are it will be covered in clouds for days. However, it does deliver a fantastic view towards the mountain Sornfelli and Vagar with the iconic cliff the Witch's Finger on a clear day. There are several places you can get a beautiful picture here. You can either shoot from the brink, walk a little bit up the mountain where I got a nice shot with Sophie in the foreground, or you can venture out on the hiking trail, which is one of the most sketchy and advanced trails in the Faroes.
So we have come here to this absolutely spectacular view. Just look at this, like, this scene is just, this is the Faroe Islands, fantastic. So I'm going here along this ridge, along with Sophie, and we are just trying to find a lot of interesting places to have her as a foreground, and then we have the view as the background. It is incredibly windy, so it is a tiny bit dangerous, and if you go up here and if it's windy, be sure to stay on the ground and don't fly away. So we are very careful about where we can go and where we can't go. And it is just super, super important that you know what you're doing. But I can see Sophie is getting ready for the next one. So I'm shooting without a tripod. I'm just like hammering off handheld, and hopefully it's a bit spray and pray when it's so windy as it is right now.
Despite the crazy wind and partly blue sky, I managed to pull off some decent atmospheric photos. I especially like the last of the upcoming collection.
So now we're in Jekf. I didn't really feel that I managed to get something proper from this beautiful little settlement last time I was here. So now we're just hiking a little bit up towards west from the settlement, and hopefully we should be able to get a really beautiful view towards the mountain here in the background. there's quite a lot of places you can park your car in the town, and there's also a few different ways to get up there, so it shouldn't be too hard to find. It's basically just along the ridge up here where we want to go. It's actually beautiful weather for a walk. It's a bit hard for many photographers, myself included, when it's just all clear weather. We have a few clouds coming in from west right now, and in this case I actually, yeah, it would be nice with a few puffy clouds, but the main thing I want to photograph is the Faroese summer, where the grass is just so green and all the slopes and mountains are green. And then we have the ocean reflecting the blue sky, so the ocean is blue too. We get these very beautiful deep colors of blue and green. So it is a quite nice little hike. The clouds are getting thicker and thicker, so I have already taken a few shots, so I think I'm good, but it would be nice to have both the foreground and the settlement lit also, which it actually is right now. Looks quite nice. But we still have a little bit more to go, so it's just about pushing on. So right now it's actually super duper pretty, because we have the sun in a low angle to the slopes, so we have a lot of shadows all the way down, which gives a lot of depth and dynamic to the photo. Because right now the sky is still a little bit boring. I'm not sure if I'm going to put in a few clouds, but all in all, it's super, super pretty. So I'm taking panoramas, vertical panoramas, all the way around with my 24 millimeter. Oh, the main problem right now is that I actually get my own shadow on the photos. So I need shadow just where I'm standing to get it right. And then I need the rest lit by the sun. Then it will turn out really, really well. So we're still not at the top, so I want to get up there. So finally at the top, and it is quite stunning. Right here at the top where you cross this ladder to the next field, the perspective is not good at all. You have to go a little bit down, and even then you will have the fence in the picture. I'm not entirely sure how it will turn out. I think I will fly my drone like a bit in here to get a bit higher perspective, just to get the cliffs down here also. So off with that one. Thank you. from up here you can actually see all the way to Kalsoy from episode 4. And that's one of the things I like so much about the Faroe Islands. If you get up high enough, you can basically see it all, and you can see where you're walking, so you kind of feel as if you're on top of the world. So yeah, that was a good day over there, for sure.
So it has been a little while since I've recorded my last video, and as I mentioned back then, the workshop season has begun and I'm quite occupied with that. I do have a couple of months home here in December and January, but I'm quite occupied with other stuff, so I will need to attend that. That means that there will be a little bit more time between the release of my videos. That, however, shouldn't influence the quality of the videos, as I've already recorded most of it. Now, I do have a video also coming out on all my gear, and it's supposed to come out here probably next week or something like that. So also all the workshops I've set up for the Faroe Islands, two with Nick Page and two with Nigel Danson, are all sold out, and that is so cool. And thank you all so much, and I'm looking very much forward to meeting you all out there. Now, I do have a few more spots open for the tour to Lofoten, which I am running with my good friend Tor Ivar. He's a local up there, and he's the head of Nordic Photo Tours. Also, I have a few more spots available on the tours I'm running for Iceland Photo Tours in February and March. So go into icelandphototours.com if you want to join me in Iceland. So if you want any news on workshops and release of new tutorials and other kinds of news, be sure to subscribe to my newsletter down in the description. That is my primary source for reaching everybody who is actually interested in what I'm doing beside the videos or my pictures. So yeah, down in the description. And as always, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. I would highly appreciate both a like and a comment.